Last night you made a joke about maybe two Republicans being in the audience. So I had an interesting experience. We got to the Ted Nugent part where you encourage everyone to dance together with someone of the same sex. And I'm straight, and I saw during the night that there was a guy near me, and he was enjoying the show. And so at that time, I turned to him, I go, hey, you want to dance? And he goes, no. And so I joined a threesome, it was good.
Yeah.
But I looked, and he was all by himself, and he wouldn't do that. So obviously he enjoyed your show, but does it surprise you that someone would be so, I don't know, put off by that human touch or male to male?
No, it doesn't surprise me at all. It's why we do the number, because you know the art in the room isn't that you do it. The art in the room is what happens. So if somebody says, no, what he gets to do is he goes home and he thinks about why he said no. He thinks about the other people that were doing it, and maybe he doesn't. Maybe he doesn't think about that. I can't control that. But the hope is that that's what ends up happening. You are thinking about him and why he didn't do it. You've asked this question now, so now we're all thinking about that. You know, so that's the art. The art isn't that it succeeds or doesn't succeed. It is what happens. So that's slightly different from the kind of theater that we're used to, where it's this Aristotelian structure, where you're going towards the end, and there's a catharsis, and something happens, and we know why that happened, and blah, 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 blah. This is more, there's doubt. There is doubt in the room. And so that's the hope.